Howdy everyone, my name is Keeper.
Been a little while since I've done one of these vlogs. It feels kind of weird, actually. I don't have the, I guess I could put the headset on. I feel a little bit better. No? Okay, fine. But I'm back from PAX East. You might hear I'm a little stuffed up. I caught a little bit of a bug or something, but I'm feeling a lot better. There's a lot of changes going on to the channel, just in life and stuff, and I wanted to throw that out here for anyone who wants to be able to keep up with everything that's going on, because Lord knows I can't. So we'll start at the top. Yes, I went to PAX East. I'm planning on going to PAX West as well, so I hit all of them this year. Maybe Unplugged. We'll see. But I had a lot of fun. I actually met Matt and Lizzie, Bowling Honor, and there are mods and a lot of other YouTubers. It was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it a lot. These conventions are a lot of fun, and I'm really glad I have the opportunity to be able to go to them. That being said, I am recovering from being sick, and I'm trying to do as much recording as I can in that time. I had the Mad Father stuff go out while I was gone. I think that only had the 8 episodes though, so that should be ran out by now. But we'll begin videos going up again as soon as I possibly can. But for now, it is Saturday by the time you guys are seeing this, and you might be thinking, where's the stream? Well, because I don't know if this will go up before or after the stream. Whoops. You might not be thinking that. Point being, I'm not streaming on YouTube anymore. I know I used to do, I would stream Saturdays on YouTube and I would stream Sundays on Twitch for the longest time. That's how I did it. I even used to stream Saturdays and Mondays on YouTube, but I've since moved everything over to Twitch. I am now streaming almost every day on Twitch, starting at 6 p.m. MST, playing variety of stuff, playing horror games, random funny games, early access, Sea of Thieves, all kinds of stuff. And I might fall into a better routine of doing specific games more often than others. We'll see. I was doing Sea of Thieves more often for a while. I'll probably jump back into that for a bit, but as of right now, I'm just kind of playing whatever I want to play. Playing a lot of Getting Over It recently because I want to get over it. But my point being, every stream is now being done on Twitch. It's the same time, like I said, almost every day. I'm actually aiming for every day, but sometimes I have to take a day off to be able to do things, whatever. But everything's on Twitch now. So that leads me into the next part of the changes that are coming to the channel. You might have already, you know, picked up on that, obviously, the way that I'm doing recording formats differently and editing formats differently, and that's the way the videos are uploaded. All of that is changing, I think, for the better. YouTube has taken a direction where the standard Let's Play format is no longer palatable for most people. The people who have made it big doing that will stay big doing that, and you know, that's fine, that's how they started. But to the average viewer, you can't do that anymore as a new channel. So that leaves me with two options. One is the more popular thing that's come up is you do, you know, full games or full chunks of games and you cut it down, but it's like, that takes a 3 hour Let's Play into 15 minutes. Which is cool, and I mean, I even enjoy watching some of those, but that's not my style of how I do videos. I have friends who do those kinds of videos. They're great, but it's just not for me. My style is definitely a traditional Let's Play. I sit here, I play the game, I do bad jokes, I scream at things, and then, you know, we share those experiences. But that's just not the direction that YouTube is able to be taken anymore. Twitch is definitely more suited for that style. It's why I'm doing more stuff over there. Because that's what Twitch is for. That's what streaming's for. You sit there, you play the game, you interact with people live. It's so much better for my kind of format. But there are certain games I think are still better suited for a YouTube series rather than a stream. A lot of horror things fall into that kind of category. A lot of the RPG stuff falls into that, like Yamawari, Mad Father, those kinds of things I would love to stay doing as YouTube series rather than streams. And really the only reason I say that is because I'm able to cut them down into 10 to 15 minute chunks and make them just a longer series. That's kind of the compromise between doing a standard Let's Play and a highly edited, you know, one video Let's Play. It's not even really a Let's Play, a gaming video. Kind of the compromise is instead of doing a longer traditional Let's Play episode, you kind of have to break that down into parts now. So whereas before I would play one part of a horror game for 20 to 30 minutes, now I would split that into three videos almost, 10 to 15 minutes each. So in the long run, it does give me more videos and more content, so I guess in a way it's kind of an easy way out to make sure I have videos ready. But at the same time, it's a choice I'm making purely for the channel and for the channel statistics, the way I'm able to see them. It's just better that way. Just in the direction that I've taken in the time I have, in the direction that YouTube has taken, and how people want to view their content, I'm going to be sticking to that kind of format where I'm still doing longer Let's Plays, but they're shorter episodes each, and there'll just be more episodes per full series. Some people aren't gonna like that. I totally understand. I'm not really on board with it either, but that's just how things are gonna be. Also, unfortunately, because of that, well, maybe not unfortunately specifically, but in the way that I record, I have to record multiple videos in a single sitting. Whereas before, I could record like 4 games at a time, like I said, playing them for 20 minutes each. I'd just do, you know, a video for each episode. I'd get through all these kinds of games, put out a whole variety on the channel. It was great. I had a lot of fun playing all the different games at once. Whereas now I kind of have to pick 1 or 2 games to record just based on the time that I have available to me, and have to record, you know, 4 to 5 episodes in a single sitting. And the way that transitions into making videos is if I'm recording 4 episodes of 2 different games, so I have 8 episodes ready, then I have to edit those. That would mean the next week may only comprise of those 2 games, if that makes sense. If I'm putting out a video every day or every, you know, 5 days a week, whatever, I'd only have 2 games ready. I wouldn't be able to put out the same variety that I put out. It would probably end up being more like when I did, you know, Madfather, when I was away, I did 1 every day, because those were the videos I had ready. I specifically recorded those for while I was away, so that even though it was just 1 single series, there was 1 video going out every day, and I was able to record that in less than 3 hours, all those. And it's just because of how short the time is per video that requires me to record more when I play it. Because if I only sit and play Yamawari for 15 minutes, I'm not going to be able to get anywhere, because first off, I'm going to forget those 15 minutes, you know, half an hour later, and I'm just going to have to keep coming back anyway. So I might as well record, you know, for 1 hour or 2 in that 1 series, and then even if I do have to put them all out the next week, at least I'm making progress in those games. So that's something I definitely need to talk about here in this vlog, was the direction the channel is taking. If you only see 1 to 2 series running at a time, don't panic. Everything is still gonna be finishing up. It's just how I have to record and edit now, and the way I have to put out videos now is going to change. So if you don't see West of Loathing for a while, if you don't see, if Yamawari takes a break, I don't know, if Madfather doesn't return for a freaking another 2 weeks, everything's coming. It's just I have to be more careful. First off, I'm sick, so I haven't really been recording too much. I recorded a little bit yesterday. I'm gonna record a little bit after this. Get back into it best I possibly can. This will go out Saturday, videos will come out Monday on, whatever, but everything's still coming, everything's still here. The actual content on the channel, the actual games on the channel aren't changing a lot. They really aren't. They're still the games that I want to play. They're still horror games, there's still RPG games, there's still whatever random stuff I want to do. It's just the way they're presented that is changing. And it's not entirely my choice that they are changing that way. It's just the way that I'm being forced in a lot of ways to change them. I'm probably repeating myself at this point, but I have to change it because of 1, how YouTube just accepts videos. It's changed their algorithm so much that I kind of have to deal with it. Even as a small channel, as someone who wants to grow, that's even more important for me to deal with their algorithm. And 2, because of how my time has changed. My available time to be able to record and edit has changed drastically, and I need to be able to fit everything into 1 schedule. I'm only 1 person. I can only do so much, but I'm trying. And to kind of tie in with that last point, for as far as my schedule goes, I am streaming every night for 3 to 4 hours over on Twitch, because that's the time frame I have available. Right now, 6 to 9 my time, so 6 p.m. MST every night, give or take, I'll be over there. It's just, Twitch is a much, much better platform to be on right now. YouTube has taken a downhill tumble, and Twitch is there to try to pick up the slack, and it's a really, really great platform. Even for smaller creators like me, I have found almost immediate success moving over there. Apart from raids from people, from, you know, sending over new viewers and followers, but that's part of the beauty of Twitch. Friends can help each other out to grow on this amazing platform. I can be supported directly by people who want to support me, and I can be supported by the site, It's so much more rewarding to put in the time on Twitch than it is on YouTube. If I want to turn any of this into a career, Twitch would be the place for me to do it. And that's just the unfortunate truth. YouTube is how I got into all this online content creating. It's how I got into editing in the first place. And Twitch doesn't require editing. Really, it really doesn't. But it still is part of my passion of being there and interacting with people and playing games and just having a good time. Why would I not choose that platform for that when YouTube has treated small creators so badly? Like, it's been really difficult for me to deal with the demonetization. Not necessarily, I've said this on my Twitter before, it's not because I lost money. I wasn't making any money off my channel, if that wasn't obvious. I made like 2 cents in a month once. Hell yeah. But no, I was actually partnered with an MCN that had to drop me because you can't, or I couldn't be partnered with them, or maybe you just can't be partnered in general, but they had to drop me because I didn't meet that threshold. And when they dropped me, I lost a lot of benefits. I lost a lot of benefits that came with that. And that hurt. I lost a full sound library, which to an editor, losing a sound library sucks. Let me tell you right now. I lost optimization tools, which every time I post a video would help me find tags and titles and be able to get my video out. Because that's not the part I excel in. It isn't. And it knows the YouTube algorithm. It can tell me, hey, these might be useful to you. Let's try and, you know, compare your title to these titles and yada yada. I have a similar service now. Now I have to pay for. That's another thing that I have to factor in everything else. If I still want to be able to have that optimization, I have to pay for it. Is it worth it? I don't know. But right now I'm on a free trial thing, so I'll figure it out. But there's a lot of little things that have made me want to do more Twitch. And so I am. I'm just doing more Twitch. So that's really it. It's all I really wanted to say. It's just, I know I kind of ranted a little bit, but it's just, I'm not stopping YouTube. Obviously, the way I'm going to approach YouTube is going to change drastically. It has already changed drastically, and it's only going to keep changing from there. And I'm going to be spending a lot more time on Twitch. So if you are interested in following me further, the channel will still be here. It'll still have the content that's been going out recently. That's the kind of content that will be. If that's not your cup of tea, I totally understand. Cup of tea. Get it, because they have tea. Yeah, funny. But if you still want the longer style Let's Plays, I'm going to be over on Twitch doing pretty much just that every night, 6 p.m. MST. And I still get this in my comments all the time, that you can't come to Twitch because you don't have Twitch. You don't have to have a Twitch. It's a website. You can come over to Twitch and just watch me from there. There's a link in the description. It's on all of my videos to my Twitch page. You can watch me live there, same time. And if you get there and you figure it out and you decide you like me over there too, you can make an account at which you can then follow me on there. And then you'll be notified from there as well. But I've gone on way too long talking about the same thing. Sounds like over and over and over again, I'm certain. But that's just... It's only fair of me to update this channel with everything that's going on. So I really appreciate the support, everyone who's been here, everyone who's come over to the Twitch channel already, and I hope to see the rest of you over there too, because there's a lot of people that did only come to the YouTube streams, which is why I kept doing them for a while, that I don't want to leave, right? I want everyone to be able to, you know, enjoy the streams together. So if you want to, do come over to the Twitch channel. I promise it's a lot of fun. It's free. You don't even really need an account just to watch, just if you want to chat. But that'll do it for now, and hope to see you next time so we keep on gaming together. Until then, see ya.